गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. कैन यू हियर मी?
यस मैम.
ऑल राइट. ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टर्म, द न्यू टर्म एसोसिएटेड विद द रेक्टिलिनियर मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट इज वेलोसिटी. ओके, एंड वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वेलोसिटी. So first of all, we can recall about this. After that, we can move to the next term associated with the rectilinear motion. So before that, all of you, please switch on your videos. Those who are sitting in the physics class, please switch on your videos. Okay. So now we can start with the Mary Angelina. What do you mean by velocity?
Ma'am, the speed of an object with a definite direction.
Okay, it is the speed of an object with a definite direction. That is one definition for velocity. One more definition is that. What is that?
Ma'am, rate of change in displacement with time.
Okay, it is the rate of change of displacement of an object. Very good. So the speed of an object with a definite direction is known as velocity, or it is the rate of change of displacement of an object is known as velocity. So next question to Mehreen.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the equation for calculating the velocity?
Velocity equal to displacement by time.
Velocity equal to displacement by time. What is the SI unit?
Meter per second.
Okay, very good. Alina Varghese. Dimension for velocity. What is the dimension for velocity?
Lt raised to -1.
Lt raised to -1. Very good. One more question, Alina. What are the different types of velocity?
Uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity.
Yes.
Instantaneous velocity.
Instantaneous velocity. Very good. We have different types of velocity. They are uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity, and instantaneous velocity. And students, can you identify the nature of physical quantity? The velocity is comes under which type of physical quantity? Is it a scalar or vector?
Vector.
It is a vector quantity. Velocity is a yes. Velocity is a vector quantity because it has both magnitude and a direction. That is what is we are already discussed in its definition. Velocity is a speed of an object with a definite direction. So the velocity possesses a unit. Along with that, it indicates a direction. So we can call the velocity as a vector quantity. Now we can discuss the different types of velocity. So starting with Tom Sebastian. Tom, what do you mean by uniform velocity? Okay, I think some audio problems are there anyway. Right. So the next question to, the same question to Devi Krishna.
A body is said to be in uniform velocity if it covers equal displacement and equal time.
In equal, if the body covers equal displacement in equal intervals of time, we can call it as uniform velocity. I think the same answer is told by the Tom Sebastian. Okay, very good dear. The next question to Abhinav. Please switch on your video.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what do you mean by non-uniform velocity? Abhinav, non-uniform velocity. If the object covers equal displacement,
displacement.
Okay, dear. I think some connectivity issues are there. Same question to Alan. Alan Joshi.
Ma'am, an object covers unequal displacement in equal interval of time.
Yes, if the object covers unequal displacement in equal intervals of time, we can call it as non-uniform velocity. So the next velocity is average velocity. Questions to Annelies. Equation for calculating average velocity.
Yes, ma'am. Average velocity is equal to total displacement by total time taken.
total displacement divided by total time taken, and then align. What is the equation for calculating average velocity in equation form?
Ma'am, x2 minus x1 by t1 minus t2 minus t1.
Yes, s2 minus s1 divided by t2 minus t1. S2 and s1 is the final displacement and the initial displacement, then divided by t2 minus t1. T2 is the time corresponding to the final displacement. T1 is the time corresponding to the initial displacement. So average velocity is s2 minus s1 divided by t2 minus t1. The next question is to Samia. What do you mean by instantaneous velocity? Samia, instantaneous velocity. Same question to Sahan. Instantaneous velocity. You can say the definition from this term itself. What do you mean by instantaneous? Instantaneous velocity. Same question to Devika Girish.
It is the velocity of an object at a given instant of time.
Very good. It is the velocity of an object for a given instant of time. It is the velocity of an object for a particular instant of time is known as instantaneous velocity. So the next question to Adulya. What is the equation for calculating the instantaneous velocity of an object?
Limit delta t tends to zero, delta x by delta t.
Limit delta t tends to zero, delta x divided by delta t is the instantaneous velocity, same as that of the equation for the speed. So today we are going to discuss the next term associated with the rectilinear motion of an object, that is acceleration. The next term associated with the rectilinear motion of an object is known as acceleration. So all of you write the next heading, acceleration. The next term associated with the rectilinear motion of an object is known as acceleration. Have you heard about this term acceleration? I know that this is not a new term for you. What do you mean by acceleration? Any idea?
It is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time.
Okay, it is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. That is what is we were already studied in our 9th standard, right? 9th physics, we are already studied about the acceleration. And you can relate this acceleration, the term acceleration, exactly with that of a device that we are used in our practical life. Have you heard about accelerator? Accelerator that we are used in our vehicle. What is the use of accelerator in vehicles? In car or in two-wheelers, we are use this accelerators. What is the use of accelerators?
To increase speed.
Yes, it is used to either increase or only to increase the speed. The accelerators are used to only to increase the speed. If we want to make it is slow down, we can release the accelerator, then it is also reduces the speed of the vehicle. So the accelerator is mainly used in vehicle. It is a device that is used either to increase or reduce the speed of the vehicle, right? That is, we can change the speed of the vehicle with the help of accelerator. Similarly, the term acceleration means we can increase or decrease the velocity of a moving body. Okay, we can increase or decrease the velocity of a moving body. That is what is we can measure, how we can measure the velocity, the change in velocity of a object in motion. If we want to measure the change in velocity of the object in motion, we want a physical quantity. So that physical quantity is known as acceleration. So acceleration is a physical quantity that measures the rate of change of velocity of an object. Okay, so all of you write the definition for acceleration. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity of an object. The rate of change of velocity of an object with the time is called acceleration of a body. And how this acceleration is denoted or how it is indicated, which letter is used to denote represent the acceleration?
A.
Well, A, small letter A. Small letter A is used to denote the acceleration. Small letter A is used to denote acceleration. Acceleration means the rate of change of velocity of an object with the time is called the acceleration of a body. Or mathematically, we can define acceleration, change in velocity divided by time taken. Acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time taken. Acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time taken. Now you don't need to copy down about the average acceleration. We will discuss about it later. Only write the definition for acceleration and the mathematical equation for calculating the acceleration. Acceleration is equal to change in velocity divided by time taken. Or we can write A is equal to V by T. That is, rate of change of velocity of an object is known as acceleration. Now we can define the unit of acceleration. Okay, so Jewel, what is the unit of velocity? Unit of velocity?
Meter per second.
Meter per second. What about the unit of time?
Time, T, second.
Second, okay. So here we are going to brought this second to the numerator. So we get meter per second square. Meter per second square. So the SI unit of acceleration. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Then what about the dimension? Here the SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Now we can find the dimension of acceleration. What is the dimension of velocity, Pooja? Dimension of velocity?
L t raised to negative 1.
This is the dimension of velocity. Then Gaya, what is the dimension of time?
T.
Dimension of time is T. So now we are going to brought this time to here. So it becomes LT raised to minus 1. Again one more T raised to minus 1. So what is the dimension of acceleration? Nimida?
LT raised to minus 2.
Put it in a square bracket. So this is the dimension of acceleration. Dimension of acceleration is LT raised to minus 2. We are already studied in our previous chapter. The dimension of acceleration is LT raised to minus 2. SI unit is meter per second square. Now students, one more question. Can you identify the type of physical quantity? Our acceleration comes under which type of physical quantity? John Jones.
Scalar.
Is it a scalar or vector? Is it scalar quantity? Our velocity is comes under which physical quantity? Is it is a scalar or vector?
Vector.
So our acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. Some physical quantity that is related to velocity. We know that velocity is a vector quantity. So what about the acceleration? Acceleration is also a vector quantity. Acceleration is a vector quantity. So these are the some characteristics of acceleration. So acceleration is the next term associated with that of the rectilinear motion of an object. It is the rate of change of velocity of a body of a moving object is known as acceleration, and its SI unit is meter per second square. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Dimension of acceleration is LT raised to minus 2. And here we know that acceleration is a physical quantity, that is the rate of change of velocity. since velocity is a vector quantity, our acceleration is also a vector quantity. It possesses both magnitude and direction. Is it clear? Now, one more point regarding with this acceleration. The acceleration can be either positive, negative, or zero. The acceleration of a moving body can be either positive, negative, or zero. Okay. So the acceleration of a body can be either positive, negative, or zero. So depending upon that, we can classify the acceleration into two. One is positive acceleration and other is negative acceleration. The acceleration can be positive, negative, or zero. Depending upon that, we can classify the acceleration into two. Acceleration can be classified into two. One is positive acceleration. And what is the next classification? If one is positive acceleration, next one is?
Acceleration.
Ah, yes.
Negative acceleration.
Okay, so now we can define what you mean by positive acceleration and negative acceleration. Students, now we have an idea about what you mean by acceleration. What is acceleration? Alendina, what is acceleration?
Rate and change of velocity with time.
Yes, it is the rate of change of velocity of an object with respect to time. Rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity means here the velocity can either be increased with respect to time or be decreased with respect to time, right? So here we are going to define positive acceleration. If the velocity of the moving body, if the velocity of the object increases with respect to time, we can call it as positive acceleration. So what is positive acceleration? If the velocity of the moving body or the moving object, velocity is increases. It is increases with respect to time, we can call it as positive acceleration. If the velocity of the moving body is increases with respect to time, it is called positive acceleration. So now it's your turn. Form a definition for negative acceleration.
If the velocity of the body decreases with respect to time.
Very good. Excellent. If the velocity of the body decreases with the time. If the velocity is decreases with respect to time, then we can call it as negative acceleration. So acceleration can have positive, negative, or zero values. Based on that, the acceleration is mainly classified into two. One is positive acceleration. Next is another is negative acceleration. In positive acceleration, the velocity of the body is increases with respect to time. And the negative acceleration, as its name implies, it is the velocity of the object is decreases with respect to time. Okay. And this negative acceleration is also known by one more name, that is retardation. The negative acceleration is also known as retardation. So in negative acceleration, velocity is decreases with respect to time. The negative acceleration is also known as retardation. Or in some textbook, you can find one more word, deceleration. Okay, so the negative acceleration is also known as retardation or deceleration. So these are the top points that come under the negative acceleration. Negative acceleration means if the velocity of an object is decreases with respect to time, it is negative acceleration. It is also known as retardation or deceleration. So in question paper, sometimes you maybe find these two terms, retardation and deceleration. It is nothing. It is our negative acceleration itself. Is it clear? Okay. So once again, we can go. Anushwaram, Can you differentiate the positive and negative acceleration? Differentiate between positive.
Velocity increasing with respect to time is known as positive acceleration and velocity.
Okay, continue. Then the Fahis, what do you mean by negative acceleration? Fahis Faisal, what do you mean by negative acceleration? Fahis, are you there? Please switch on your video. The same question to Nehal. What do you mean by negative acceleration? Yes, if the velocity is decreases with respect to time, it is called a negative acceleration. And the next question to Tom Sinjan. What is the other name for negative acceleration?
Retardation or deceleration.
Retardation or deceleration. Okay. Now we can discuss the different types of acceleration. Just similar to that of the velocity, here the acceleration is again classified into different types. They are uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, average acceleration, and instantaneous acceleration. So all of you write the next heading. Types of acceleration. Types of acceleration. So here we have four different types of acceleration similar to that of the velocity and speed. The first one is uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration. Can you guess what you mean by uniform acceleration? Any idea? Here I will give you a table. Time is in seconds, velocity in meter per second. Time varies from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 seconds. And the velocity 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay. So students, can you guess what about the velocity corresponding to 5 seconds? Velocity corresponding to 5 seconds?
12.
Velocity corresponding to 2 seconds?
6.
Okay, 6. So my next question, what about the difference between the time interval? What is the difference between the time interval?
1.
It is 1. The difference between the time interval is 1 second. Similarly, what is the difference between the velocity?
2.
2 meter per second. So now can you form a definition for uniform acceleration? Here the object possesses equal amount of velocity in equal intervals of time. If the object possesses equal amount of velocity in equal intervals of time, we can call it as uniform acceleration. So what is uniform acceleration? If equal changes or velocity takes place in equal intervals of time, we can call it as uniform acceleration. All of you write the definition for uniform acceleration. If the object changes its velocity in equal intervals, if it is changes equal velocity in equal intervals of time, then we can call it as uniform acceleration. Only need to write the definition for uniform acceleration. If the object is possess equal velocity in equal intervals of time, we can call it as uniform acceleration. Examples for uniform acceleration is the motion of a freely falling body. If an object comes under the freely falling, or if the object is freely falling from a particular height, it is possess uniform acceleration. Or the motion of a sliding block on a smooth inclined plane is also examples for uniform acceleration. It covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. So the object reaches at the ground, it covers equal velocity in equal intervals of time, so we can say that it is comes under the uniform acceleration. Write the definition for uniform acceleration, and you can note two examples for uniform acceleration. One is the motion of a freely falling body, and the second one the motion of a sliding block, or the motion of a block on a sliding plane. These two are come under the category of this uniform acceleration. Is it over?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Uniform acceleration, if equal changes of velocity takes place in equal intervals of time, we can call it as uniform acceleration. All of you please switch on your videos. Nehal, Dia, Alina, Vargis, Malavika, Vibin, Samia, Anashura, Agna, Anaga, Eva, Abhinav, all of you please switch on your videos. Okay, now the second type of acceleration. What is the second type of acceleration then? The first one is uniform acceleration. What about the second type? Yes, unmute and say.
Non-uniform.
Non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration. So here I will give you a table. Here we have time in seconds, velocity in meter per seconds. The velocity varies from okay. Now, what about this type of motion of an object? This table is represents the motion of an object or the velocity possessed by a moving object in a given interval of time. What is the difference between the time interval possessed by the moving body? Difference in time. It is 2 seconds. They are equal. The time interval is equal. Now, what about the velocity? Difference between velocity. Here it is 7 meter per second. What about the difference in velocity between 17 and 21? Difference in velocity between 17 and 21? Yes, it is 4 meter per second. Does they are same? They are same or not?
No.
No. So can you form a definition for non-uniform acceleration? Eva, try to make a definition for non-uniform acceleration of an object.
Yes, ma'am. If unequal changes of velocity take place in equal intervals of time.
Yes, it is the unequal amount of velocity in equal intervals of time. If the object possesses unequal amount of velocity in equal intervals of time, we can call it as non-uniform acceleration. So all of you write the definition for non-uniform acceleration. In uniform acceleration, we have the object is covers or it is possesses equal amount of velocity in equal intervals of time. But in non-uniform acceleration, a body is said to be moving with a non-uniform acceleration if its velocity is increases by unequal amounts. It is changes by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time. Not only increases, sometimes it may be decreases. So here you can write, if the velocity of the body is changes, instead of this changes, here you can write increases, you can write changes. If the velocity of the object is changes by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time, we can call it as non-uniform acceleration. An example for the non-uniform acceleration is the motion of the car in a crowded street or in a heavy traffic road. it possesses a non-uniform acceleration. The time interval will be the equal, but it covers or it possesses unequal amount of velocity. For 2 seconds, sometimes it may be covers 5 meters per second. Or in next 4 seconds, sometimes it may be covered 10 meters per second and all. Okay, so this is an examples for non-uniform acceleration. A body is said to be moving with a non-uniform acceleration, which implies that if it is possess unequal, if the velocity is changes unequal amounts in equal intervals of time. So here we have two different types of acceleration, uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration. In uniform acceleration, the body is said to be in uniform if the velocity is changes in equal amounts in equal intervals of time. In non-uniform acceleration, the velocity is changes in unequal amounts in equal intervals of time. Is it over?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we can discuss the third type of acceleration. What is the third type? It is average acceleration. Average acceleration. The third type of acceleration is average acceleration. Okay, suppose if we are consider the motion of an object for different velocities, in such cases we need to calculate the average amount of acceleration. In order to find out the rate of motion of an object, in such cases we need to calculate the average value of the acceleration. So average acceleration is defined as the change in velocity of a body divided by total time taken. Okay, change in velocity of a body divided by total time taken. Average acceleration is given by, it is the change in velocity. Change in velocity means final velocity minus initial velocity. Suppose if we take the final velocity as v2, initial velocity as v1, divided by the time taken, t2 minus t1. So this is the average velocity. Average velocity is given by delta v divided by delta t. This delta means it is a small change. The change occurs to the term velocity. Delta is indicates the change. So delta v means change in velocity. Change in velocity means change in the final velocity and that of the initial velocity. Change or the difference between the final velocity and the initial velocity. V2 minus v1 divided by delta t. Delta t means change in the time, t2 minus t1. That is the time taken for the final velocity and the time taken for the initial velocity. Okay, so the average acceleration is represented by a bar. So we can represent average acceleration by a bar. Simple acceleration is represented by simply the letter a, but for average acceleration we are representing a bar is equal to delta v divided by delta t. And this delta is indicates a small change. A small change, that is a bar is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by change in time, that is t2, that is the time corresponding to the final velocity v2, and t1, that is the time corresponding to the initial velocity v1. So a bar is equal to v2 minus v1 divided by t2 minus t1. This is the equation for calculating the average velocity. Okay, so that's all about the average velocity. Now we have one more type of acceleration. What is that? What is the next type of acceleration? Instantaneous acceleration. So the next one is instantaneous acceleration. Instantaneous acceleration. Now, what do you mean by instantaneous acceleration? Now you are already studied about the instantaneous displacement, instantaneous velocity and all. So can you form a definition for instantaneous acceleration? Instantaneous acceleration, instantaneous.
Acceleration of a body in
the... Yes, very good. It is the acceleration of a body or the object at any instant of time, at a particular instant of time. Okay, so it is defined as the acceleration of an object at any instant of time during its motion is called a instantaneous acceleration. Instantaneous means quickly, the suddenly, the sudden acceleration. So instantaneous velocity means it is the velocity of the moving body at a particular instant of time. Similarly, instantaneous acceleration, it is the acceleration of an object or a moving body at a given instant of time is called instantaneous acceleration. And mathematically, we can represent instantaneous acceleration equal to dv by dt, where this d by dt is represents the small change in the velocity of the object. Instantaneous acceleration, or in just similar to that of this instantaneous velocity, here also we can form an equation for instantaneous acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration means it is the acceleration of an object at any instant of time. Similarly, the instantaneous acceleration, the instantaneous acceleration, a instant is equal to limit. Limit, what about the time? Just a similar, yes. Delta t tends to?
Zero.
Delta t tends to zero. Delta v by delta t. Delta v by delta t. Because acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. And here we measure instantaneous acceleration, acceleration at a particular instant of time, within a short interval of time. So we can write this limit delta t tends to zero, delta v divided by delta t. Or here we can avoid this terms limit delta t tends to zero, delta by delta, by writing instantaneous acceleration, a instant is equal to dv by dt. These two equations are possible for instantaneous acceleration. Okay. So here we discuss some terms associated with the rectilinear motion of an object. We are starting from distance and displacement. Then the next two terms, speed and velocity, then the last and final term that is related to the rectilinear motion of an object is the acceleration. All of you please switch on your videos. Okay. So Lakshmi, what is the equation for calculating the instantaneous acceleration?
Limit delta t tends to zero delta v divided by delta t.
So with this we are discussing all the terms associated with the rectilinear motion of an object, and when you are observed you can find a relation between all these terms. So all these terms are associated with the rectilinear motion of an object. Rectilinear motion, what do you mean by rectilinear motion? Recall once again, what do you mean by rectilinear motion?
straight line motion.
Yes, the motion of an object in a straight line is called a rectilinear motion. The first two terms associated with the rectilinear motion is? One is? Oh, yes.
Distance.
And the second term is displacement. The next two terms are associated with this distance and displacement somehow. Okay. Then Navaneet, what is the next term associated with the distance? The rate of change of distance of a body is called? Rate of change of distance of a body, or the distance divided by time taken by the object, is known as? Diya. Distance covered by the object divided by time taken is known as? Anjana. Why are you remaining silent? Please switch on your videos. What is the next term associated? Speed. The distance associated with speed. The next term associated with the rectilinear motion. The distance covered by the object in time taken is known as speed. Similarly, what about the next physical quantity that is related to displacement? Rate of change of displacement is very good. It is velocity. Then today we discuss the last term associated with the rectilinear motion, that is something related to velocity. What is that?
Acceleration.
So this is the complete picture of all the terms that is related to the rectilinear motion of an object. We are starting with the distance and the displacement. And the next two quantities, speed and velocity. Speed is related with the distance. That is, the distance covered by the object in time taken is known as the speed. Similarly, displacement, rate of change of displacement of an object is known as velocity. And the last term is something related to velocity. Rate of change of velocity of a body is known as acceleration. Is it clear? Clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So with this, we can.